Listen, you've worked very closely with Governor McDonnell. A lot of people said that his troubles really held you back in terms of your own race to be the governor. What's your reaction to these indictments tonight?
Well, certainly they caused challenges for all of us in Virginia. And we'd like to think of ourselves, you know, we're talking about Virginia and New Jersey tonight. We like to think of ourselves as a pretty smooth running, clean state. Doesn't mean everything goes the way we all want it to all the time. This puts a dent in that. And that's not something we're happy to see. With the history we've got, which has been pretty darn good. I agree with Newt's comments, especially when I see a first lady indicted. I'm going to want to see more of this detail. The feds don't share this stuff with us when they're pursuing it. I think this one is still going to be unfolding in terms of the political versus bad behavior comparison that we're going to see unfold.
Now, you started your own investigation, though, as an attorney general, looking at some of these gifts. I mean, did you look at the list of these gifts? Very long list of gifts. The allegations are the first lady was actually helping to facilitate the relationship. I don't know. I mean, from my point of view, I'm just very curious. How does this, I mean, you were on your way to being governor. This kind of behavior took over the headlines. I mean, how do you feel now seeing this go this far?
Well, I don't think any of us are really surprised to see an indictment come out, largely because this is leaked thoroughly since the summer. Leak suggests almost unintentional, and I'm not sure that's the case. It's been bleeding out for more than 6 months, so I don't think anybody's surprised.
Are you saying the Obama administration is throwing stuff out there trying to make this worse than it is?
I don't think make it worse than it is. It is what it is. But certainly to drag out the pain and the death by a thousand cuts, I think that
I think every American has to be worried about the power of the government if they decide to come after you. And in this case, about the fact that they have indicted the First Lady, which I'm not sure I've ever remember other cases where the person who's not an office holder doesn't have the legal obligation.
Yeah, Van, you mentioned the gifts investigation that I began.
Right.
The person with the obligation with respect to gifts is the office holder.
Absolutely.
And I don't think that surprises anybody.
But as a former prosecutor, you would admit, though, if there was a conspiracy between the governor and the first lady to solicit these gifts, that's a bad thing. You think that's pretty bad, don't you?
Well, look, I think that's...
Well,
of course,
it's a bad thing. Whoa.
Yeah.
I mean,
I think it's
that hypothetical.
I mean, look, I think if you saw Governor McDonnell's statement today, he didn't really challenge the charges. He said that what his conduct wasn't illegal, but which raises some real issues about the law in Virginia. If you're allowed as a sitting officer to go out and solicit these type of gifts and accept these types of gifts, I think the bigger problem here for the Republican Party is what Van alluded to. You know, it was a year ago that the RNC came out with a rebranding effort. They came out with a report and they said that they were going to do more outreach and that they were that they were going to be more open to policy disagreements. Now, there's nothing to indicate that that's happened, but they also said we need to look at states for laboratories and Republican governors for leadership. The past two chairmen of the Republican Governors Association, one is under federal indictment, and one, Chris Christie, is under federal investigation. So they might have to look elsewhere for leadership.